Imagine being a student in today's world. Life is complicated, fast-paced, and sometimes overwhelming. Often, schoolwork takes a back seat to other attractions.
But also, this is an age group where if learning seems to take a turn toward the negative or a downward spiral, this is an age group that can rise out of it as well.
This program explores common concerns surrounding the academically unmotivated student. With Raymond Lipkowski, we'll look at ways parents and teachers can work together on this important problem. Aaron is a seventh grader who's popular with his classmates, but he's failing most major subjects. His teachers know he can do better, and they're concerned because he doesn't take schoolwork seriously. Thinking about Aaron's situation may give us some clues to how we might work with other students who aren't making the most of their opportunities to learn.
Actually, school goes by pretty quick, and I usually look forward to lunch, because after lunch, it's pretty much home free. And then you know the rest of the day is going to be pretty fun, because after fourth period, you just have one period to go. And then you have shop and PE, and those are the best times. Two classes that I really hate and are really boring are science and math. I try to get there about 5 minutes early so I can start doing my homework or something.
I know.
1-0.
My favorite class is gym because you don't really have to do that much work. You can just play. So I really like competing against other people, trying to do to get a lot of points. And then sometimes when you're the star of it and when you start doing really good and then everyone starts to love you, and then you got a big crowd cheering for you. And that's what I like. I like the competition.
When I think about Aaron and his future, I'd say it's a little bit up in the air. I have a lot of confidence in his ability. I think the only thing I worry about is that he has to make some decisions at this point in his life pretty soon. I hope he falls in love with something, doing something, either work-related or school-wise or something. And he doesn't have that yet, except he loves attention and he loves being, you know, in the center and being a showboat. I do worry that he could go, you know, the other way.
It has come to our attention that a mysterious force is loose somewhere in outer space.
The mysteries of creation are there.
Up in the sky?
Up in the sky.
The moon and the planets are there. And new hopes for knowledge and peace are there. And therefore, as we set sail, we ask God's blessing on the most hazardous and dangerous and greatest adventure on which man has ever embarked.
Lord and Master shall bring disaster to evil factors. Demonic chapters shall be captured by kings through the storms of days after. And to the earth from the sun through triple darkness to blast ya with a force that can't be compared to any firepower, for its mind power shared. The brainwave causes vessels to circulate like constellations reflect at night off the lake.
In the first part of this program, we got to know Aaron. Like many students his age, he has the ability to do well, but he's more interested in the social aspects of school. At times, he seems to take school seriously, but when he tries and fails, he becomes frustrated and discouraged, unwilling to try again.